Okay, so there we saw how graphical system design was used to design, prototype, and deploy key embedded technologies for smart grid and renewables. Now I want to move up to something a little bit higher frequency. As you may know, NI has been investing heavily in our RF measurement platform over the last number of years. In addition to our own internal developments, we recently announced two strategic acquisitions that significantly add to our capability in this space. Phase Matrix has capability and products up to 50 gigahertz and beyond. And we'll be working with Phase Matrix to integrate those into National Instruments' platform to continue to grow our frequency coverage. AWR is a technology leader in high frequency design, or EDA. As Dr. T mentioned, in the RF space, integrating real world measurements is particularly important in design to accurately represent the real world and improve the accuracy of the design process. So to tell us more about that, I'd like to bring up two of our newest employees from AWR, Vice President of Marketing, Sherry Hess, and Solutions Architect, Josh Moore. Josh, welcome, Sherry.
Thanks.
Welcome to NI.
Thank you.
And tell us a little bit about AWR and your products.
Sure, Eric. AWR is the innovation leader in high-frequency electronic design automation software. Our primary products are Microwave Office for RF and microwave circuit design, and Visual System Simulator, or VSS, for communication systems design. With our software, engineers design RF or wireless devices, like smartphones, base stations, satellite communication systems.
So probably a few of us are familiar with kind of schematic tools, but what makes RF a little bit different?
That's a good question. So designing a circuit to operate at higher frequencies, typically above 1 gigahertz, introduces some unique challenges that aren't necessarily present at DC. So for instance, if you have two traces that are coupled close to one another in a final design, the signal from one can couple to the other, and this coupling then can degrade the circuit performance. So for this reason, engineers rely on our software to include all the physical effects of the layout, whether through models, EM, or measurements.
Cool.
So Josh, can you show us how LabVIEW can help with that?
Absolutely. LabVIEW is the perfect tool to help integrate design and test because of its signal processing and instrument control capabilities. In VSS, we're prototyping ways to connect system diagrams to LabVIEW through the LabVIEW VI integration block. If you take a closer look at the demo setup, you can see that we're using the LabVIEW RF toolkit to generate an LTE baseband signal. This waveform gets passed into the simulation model of an Infineon RF power amplifier. At the output of the amplifier, we've connected a second LabVIEW block, which demodulates and analyzes the signal.
Can you drill down into the amp and tell people a little bit more about that component?
Sure. This particular part is an Infineon cellular base station power amplifier designed to output up to 250 watts of RF power. If we take a closer look at the model in VSS, we can actually see that this entire model was designed using AWR's Microwave Office. Here we can see the circuit schematic, layout, and even a 3D model of the power amplifier.
Okay, so you're basically using LabVIEW to generate an LTE stimulus signal into this simulated component, and then you're also using LabVIEW to measure the response.
That's exactly it. When the simulation runs, we can see the results in the LabVIEW analysis block. Here we can see both a distorted constellation and spectral regrowth, both characteristics of an amplifier operating near its compression point.
Okay, but that's cool, but we know that all the designers really want to see how their simulated results compared to the actual hardware. So right here on stage, we have the Infineon PA. Josh, how about adding some real hardware in the loop using LabVIEW so we can take a look at how well simulation and measurements compare?
Okay. This third LabVIEW integration block in our diagram has been configured to talk to the vector signal generator, vector signal analyzer, and RF power amplifier in front of us. Now when the simulation runs, we can actually compare the simulated results and the measurement results side by side. As expected, the simulated results are nearly identical to the actual measurement of the device in front of us.
That's awesome. It's kind of like the dream of an RF designer to get it all in one place. Very cool. Now, I should give one caveat that this is a prototype and a little bit of a work in progress. So this will be capability that we intend to release in future versions of the AWR tools. That's very cool, though. Thank you both very much. Thanks, Sherry.
Thank you.
Josh.